It was radical. You sort of knew it was radical because there weren't a lot of people who were accepting of the whole idea. The ski community was like, we're not sure what you're doing. Say, hey, brothers, get out. Take your own damn grave in this town. You know your name, your shape and your secret. Don't leave a trail, don't dare make a sound.
I kind of copied organic looking shapes that looked like they worked well in water, and since snow is a fluid and when it's in powder form it's still a fluid, they started to work, and every board I made turned a little better than the one before.
It would have been 1976. He was out in Utah. I loaded my car and quit my job and moved out there. We made a conscious decision really to not play to a hard packed condition. We didn't want to be like a ski. We wanted to offer a different experience. We're trying to promote our product and describe what it is, and at the same time we're trying to inform people about a new sport. We're kind of transferring the feeling of surfing to snow, making that really heavy bottom turn and the way you'd slingshot up. Started in the late spring of 76, and our goal was to go to the snow show in Las Vegas in March of 77. There were no other board makers like four booths down doing anything like what we were doing. I think we walked away with a few dealers in quotes, people who are interested enough to say, yes, I'll take two, ship them when they're ready. There wasn't much growth. The product didn't take off because it was aimed at a very small market. When you got right down to it, the Winterstick was going to be used by someone who would be hiking in the backcountry. The practicalities of pulling that off are difficult, if not impossible. Financially, we weren't doing that well. We started to approach ski areas. Dimitri went and had meetings, and you know, mostly got a cold reception. And there would be, you know, quizzical questions. Why would you want to do this if you have skis? Why do we need this? How does that work? Well, what do you do in the flats? It's funny looking. Snowboard didn't want us. Alta definitely didn't want us. I don't think Brighton did either. We had our hands full trying to make product. We had our hands full trying to stay alive.
I think the whole idea of surfing on snow came from the impulse I had when I was a kid to stand on a sled, and it's a pretty natural.
I think he gave so much of himself, and you have to imagine what he did. He left college and he put all of his life savings, a lot of family money, and devoted it to this enterprise, which, you know, ultimately did not fulfill his dreams.
Had a lot of flotation and not much else.
There's probably some disappointment. He probably just doesn't want to remember a lot of the time he spent.
It's mostly because of work of people like Jake Burton and Tom Sims that snowboarding has become as big as it has. Those guys persevered on making equipment that would work on hard pack, and it's because of that that it has been accepted and it has grown to the level it is now.
I wish he would get the recognition he deserves. The fact that the sport became something and that it grew and that it was popular, that was part of our vision. The way that most of the boards are constructed today, the way the bindings were created and having edges, and we were reluctant to see that. You know, in retrospect, we weren't quick and easy. I think we achieved a good part of what we are after, which was a pure experience. And you know, the pure experience is in the backcountry or in your own little backyard or hillside.
So that first impulse led to the idea that, yeah, maybe you can surf on snow.
We're in Revelstoke, BC, and it's known to be fairly deep and dry around here. That kind of riding just leads to kind of shorter, wider shapes, older shapes maybe, swallowtails. I think it's just kind of having an idea of a shape in your head and then finding out that it works for the kind of riding you want to do.
There's definitely people that are really interested in simplifying their snowboarding experience and also at the same time trying something new, which reconnects them to something old.
We get the wood from a local mill here, so it's all trees that are cut down locally. We get a lot of snow here during the winter. Our boards are designed really just to hold their speed, to go fast in the powder, they would handle it.
Winterstick をそのフィルムで見ていたけども、その見た瞬間にあのもっとこういう風に板を。
I would hope he would feel pride. He should feel really good about the little piece that he created, we created in the history of the sport.
Dropping in 5, 4, 3, 2, drop.
Beating a plate glass window with my wrists. I never thought it could end like this. Beating a plate glass window.
We should be left on this line.
This is the first year that I've seen, you know, lots of surfing guys up on the slopes. I think they just have seen enough of it. Now they just can't stand it any longer. They got to try it.
他の板と違うので特別っていうか。
When you like hand make a board, it's a completely unique snowboard. You can be creative, you can shape it exactly how you want it, make it exactly how you want it, and it kind of has a little bit of a life to it. Just riding it, it has more of an energy to it.
There's that passion component to it. You're doing this because you love it, and what you're creating, someone's going to really love it.
こういうボードで僕らも作っていたもそうだし、そういう考えを広げていくのはもうすごく単純で、みんながすればいい。で、それを信じている人がこういうものを作っていると思うから、そういう人たちがみんな連携して、あの自分たちの信じているものを突き進んでいけば、もうあのすごく簡単。